You know, I hear people all the time saying stuff like, you know, there's too much information. You know, I hear people say they're overloaded with information. We've got too much information coming at us all the time. It's just too much. We just can't handle it. Our minds can't process it. We don't know what to do with it. And that causes anger and confusion and depression. And it's just too much information, TMI. But I'm going to be honest with you. I was watching the news a lot this weekend, and I think the opposite is true in most cases. I don't think we have too much information. I think that we don't get enough information. And the coronavirus pandemic is a perfect example of that. Here's what I mean. There was a CNN headline. 260 students and 8 teachers quarantined in Georgia school district after first week of school. Now, this seems really bad, right? It seems really bad. 1 week of school, almost 300 students and teachers have been quarantined in a place called Cherokee County, Georgia, because of the coronavirus. But the problem here is that you don't get enough information in this headline. And in fact, most of the relevant information is purposely left out. You'll notice it doesn't say 260 students and 8 teachers test positive for COVID-19. It doesn't say 260 students and 8 teachers are sick with the coronavirus and on respirators in the hospital. No, it's about students who have not tested positive, who don't show any symptoms, who may but probably are not infected with the coronavirus. They're being forced to stay home for the next 2 weeks. They're being forced to quarantine because they sat next to someone who tested positive on the bus, or they borrowed a pencil from somebody who tested positive in homeroom, or they carpooled with somebody who later tested positive. The problem with the story is we don't get enough information, and they know that. CNN knows that. They are purposely trying to make you feel more fearful about sending your kids back to school than you already do, because it looks bad, man. It looks bad. But when you dig deeper, you find out that it was only 11 students who tested positive for coronavirus. 11 students in the entire school district, 2 staff members. That's a total of 13 people who tested positive for coronavirus in the first week of school. But were they even sick? Were they asymptomatic? Are they hospitalized? What kind of contact did they have with the hundreds of other students who are now forced back into socially distant virtual learning just, you know, because? We don't know. We don't get that information from the media. The important stuff about coronavirus, they never tell you. Because this article doesn't tell you that in Cherokee County, Georgia, there are 41,000 students. 41,000 students. And 11 tested positive. Which, if Siri is correct, and she usually is 0.02% of students. 0.02% of students in Cherokee County had the coronavirus. And I'm pretty sure more students had pink eye in the first week of school than COVID-19 in Cherokee County, Georgia. 0.02%, which even when you round down is just 0%. 0%. The story we're getting from CNN is that 260 students are being forced back into quarantine after just 1 week of school because of the deadly coronavirus. But the real story, the information that we need, the information that would actually help us calm our nerves, cool our jets, feel better about ourselves, and have a positive outlook on where this country is going and make us feel more comfortable about sending our precious children back to school, the information that we really need is that 0% of their classmates have tested positive for some form of the coronavirus. Too much information is not the issue here. The real issue, clearly, is not enough.